All right. Good afternoon, everyone. You guys enjoying the Engineering Expo here at USF?
Yes!
All right, my name is Robert, and I'm presenting here at IEEE. And we have a small presentation. We're going to follow up the laser show. So, my question to you guys is, what is an engineer?
A person who makes things.
Yeah. So they're all right. Engineers use science and math to make life easier for everyone. They make buildings, roads, electronic devices. We have our skills evolve with the times to meet the needs of society. You know, 30 or 40 years ago, this was the image of an engineer. And nowadays, you would think of Iron Man. So what is an electrical engineer?
Wires.
Electrical stuff.
Yes, electrical stuff. Electrons. So, electrical engineers use the power of electricity to make the world a better place. They make the power to power your homes, power to power your cell phones, your Wii's, your iPads, electric cars, televisions, everything. All electronic devices need electrical engineers' skills. So, like I said, this is IEEE, and IEEE is an acronym. It stands for the Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers. We are a league of engineers dedicated to advancing technology innovation. What we do is we have a code of ethics that we all work by, and we standardize technology and techniques. And what that means is my cell phone that I bought here in Florida will work when I go on a road trip to California, because across the board, we all meet the same codes so that all of our devices work together. We also use these codes so our devices don't interfere with the others. You don't want this to interfere with my microphone, just the same as you wouldn't want a cell phone to interfere with someone in a hospital. So our devices are made so they don't interfere with each other, and that they work together across the board internationally. So what is electricity exactly?
Pure energy.
Power.
Heat.
But what makes electricity? What is it?
Current.
It's the current of electrons. And electrons flow down wires similar to the way that water would flow through a pipe. Water flows along through this pipe as it's being pushed, and electrons are passed through the molecules in a wire to get to where it's going. So, since this electricity is traveling, it travels through a circuit. So what are components that would be used in a circuit? What's in the wall, like electric sockets? Okay. Yes, things that are hooked together. Examples of these components are resistors, diodes, capacitors, and sensors. And when you can mix all these together in a circuit, you can create a device like an iPhone. And it needs all of those components so that you can play your Angry Birds when you get bored. An example of a circuit would be like a power line. The power is made, and it gets distributed to your home or to your building, and once it gets there, it has to go through your building, through another circuit, to get to your wall, so you can plug in your Xbox and your TV and play video games. All of these are circuits that are connected to another circuit so that they can be fine at home, entertainment. So what is a resistor? What was that?
He said things that resist stuff.
Yes, things that resist stuff. It resists electricity.
It keeps the flow of energy. It keeps back some of the energy. It keeps too much from going at once and overloading the circuit.
Exactly. It slows the current down. You don't want it to go too fast, just like in this water analogy. As water's traveling down the pipe, if you make it a smaller pipe, it slows the water down. That's what a resistor would do to electrons as it's going through a wire. It slows it down so you don't overload your circuit and break it. So, energy cannot be created or destroyed, but it can be transformed. A good example of that is with solar energy. How many people have solar panels at home or at school? You see them on your day-to-day travels. Solar panels are becoming much more popular as it's a much cheaper form of electricity. Solar panels takes the energy from the sun that hits it and transforms it to make electricity. The electricity can then go on to power your house and your electronics and to save you money. Just like the sun rays hitting those solar panels, those are light waves, and there's many other forms of waves, and these waves carry a form of energy. So, what are some examples of energy that you see on a day-to-day basis? Or hear? Deal. You have sound waves, so you can hear.
Microphone.
your phone. You have light waves, you have heat waves, you have all kinds of waves, electromagnetic waves, and you also have radio waves. And all of these forms of energy are useful in their in certain forms, and other forms you have to transform. So as an example, you have the theremin. The theremin is a musical instrument. What it does is it uses radio waves, and it transforms it over into sound. We have a theremin here up here on the stage, and I'll make it make a noise, but I can't play a song on it. The way these things work is it uses the radio waves coming from this to my hand and this one to my hand. And as this one goes further away, it gets louder. And as this one comes closer, it changes the pitch. So I'm not touching anything, but by affecting the radio waves around it, I can make sounds. And if I practice long enough, maybe a song. If you go on YouTube, you can see plenty of people that play songs with these things. They're also used to make the eerie sound in a scary movie. So what can electricity do for you?
Charge my phone.
Charge your phone.
Power your car.
Yes, power your car.
Power my PS3
and Xbox. Yes, run your house. It interacts with you all day long. It powers your homes, your schools, hospitals, and Xboxes. So here's your power system that's transferring chemical energy into electricity. And then you can play Xbox until it breaks, and then you can cook on it. So what would a world without engineers be like?
It'd be boring.
Boring, very boring. You wouldn't have all the technology, no internet.
You wouldn't
even have houses. Yeah, houses are really engineers. So engineers are a key part of society in keeping things moving. Okay, I want to recognize our sponsor, One Stop Laser Shop. They're the ones that provided us with a laser to use for today's laser show presentation. If everyone wants to look in the back of the room, there's a blue box on top of the case. That is our laser that they've let us borrow. This will be shooting the lasers up here for you to see. During the laser show, you do not want to look into that because it can blind you. So please do not look back. However, we will turn fog machines on so that you can see the lasers in the air. So during the laser show, it's okay to look up, just not back. And we will have the lights off and music playing, so enjoy the show.